Have you ever wondered what are some of the most future-proof jobs? I mean, is that even possible nowadays? I am coming to you from the future. Well, actually, I guess when you watch this, it will be the past. But today, we are going to look at some of the most future-proof jobs going into 2024. Now, I'm going to pull down the magical curtain because the reality is it would be ridiculous if I said there were jobs that were 100% future proof. But here are some that are continuing to really increase in demand. But even more importantly, we are going to look at what skills are required within each of these roles because those are the skills that will keep you, whether you are in one of these roles or not, in demand for the future. Future proofing our career. It is possible. Oh, and you know what I gotta do. I'm a YouTuber. Before you do anything, hit that subscribe, leave down in the comments other topics you want me to cover. This is how I make my videos, is based on what will help you. And also, give a video a like. Okay, enough of that YouTube stuff. Let's really get into it now. First off, imagine a job like a video game, something that you are always playing, but you never actually fully master. That's what type of jobs are going to continue to be in demand. Now, let me explain. What I mean by that is jobs that have you continuously learning and upskilling, although on one hand, it can feel like a bit of a headache. I mean, when does the learning ever stop? Well, the reality is it never stops. And that's the beauty of it, or at the very least, we need to embrace being forever learners. Also, I want to note something. For the jobs that I'm going to cover today, the three kind of main categories, my role working in tech, you know, years as a software developer, moving into developer relations and communications, my job title is not within one of these three realms I'm going to talk about today. But that's okay. Is it okay? It's okay. And if yours isn't under one of these three, it's okay too. These are just three areas that if you are looking to really grow your career within technology, that I would definitely suggest checking out. But even if you're not, the skills that these areas that we will speak about bring can translate into so many other roles. It goes back to the whole premise or the whole focus of being a forever learner. All right, I just had to get that out of the way because I didn't want someone to watch this and think, my job, I'm gonna lose my job. Like insert that meme where it's the, what is it? The dog holding the coffee cup and his house is on fire. We don't want any of that. That's not the vibe we're going for. Now, the first job that will stay in demand and really future-proof for quite a while is the data expert. What is a data expert? Well, there are so many roles under data that will stay in demand that I'm just summing it up as the data expert. Some of these roles include data scientist, data analyst, business intelligence analyst, and more. Now, where does this come from? Well, for one thing, the global data analytics market is expected to hit $272 billion. The numbers coming out of my head, it's just, it's wild, by 2027. So you can think based on these numbers, how in demand these roles will continue to be. And actually, another stat that I think is really interesting is job growth for data scientists is projected at 28% from 2020 to 2030. That is a huge increase in demand. Okay, that's great and all, but where do I go to learn some of these skills? Yes, great question. Other Tiff. Here are some resources if you are looking to grow your career around data, whether it's data science, data analyst, anything that I just mentioned. One I would recommend is Coursera's IBM Professional Certificate for Applied Data Science. Another one is Udacity's Nano Degree in Data Science. These both offer really great certifications, so it's not just a course that you can put on your resume, but you also get a certification to go alongside it. Okay, but for those of us who are not going to become data scientists or data analysts, people like myself, what can we take away from this industry of data as a whole that is continuing to grow in demand? Well, for one thing, data is touching every point now, it seems, or every company. And what I've learned, or what I'm trying to do, especially in my day-to-day role working in tech, is bringing in data-driven decisions. So making sure, whether it be for a marketing standpoint or a technical standpoint, that these decisions I am making are based on data. Now, I'm not going to be a data analyst or data scientist ever in my career. It's not what I'm looking for. But what I can do is use so many incredible tools, I mean, now with AI especially, to help me base my decisions more so focused on the data. For example, at the company I work at, we use HubSpot a lot, and they offer really great insights into what data is available, what users are clicking on, where they are traveling to, different things like that. And in turn, I can make better decisions because I have insight into that. So even if you are someone who is not looking to change your career fully or anything anything like that, really take away from this in particular that making data-based decisions, whatever your role is, will continue to set you apart. Next up is the AI whisperer. And similar to data, I am putting a few roles under this AI whisperer because there are going to be many roles under this subject of AI. I know we keep on hearing about AI, AI, but the reality is AI isn't going anywhere anytime soon. Well, probably never going anywhere. And within AI, there are so much opportunity both on the technical and non-technical side to get into. So whether you are looking to do a career switch or even grow your career in a different direction, a direction that you know is more in demand, AI as a whole is definitely a good starting point. So what are some roles within AI? This includes roles such as machine learning engineer, AI engineer, deep learning engineer, even robotics engineer I might put under AI. Maybe it should be its own category, but I think the two can be very closely linked. And then there are a ton of other roles. For example, I know IBM has a role where it's AI and data technical specialist. So it's someone that maybe has a bit of technical knowledge and experience. And yes, you're technical, but it's more so about having the knowledge of a technical person when you are selling to customers or interacting with them. All right, let's start with data though. Let's go, you know, going back to point number one, really emphasizing how important taking data or making database decisions is. What really is the percentage of role or percentage that this role will go up? Let's focus on machine learning engineer. According to Forbes, machine learning engineers are expected to soar, or jobs for it are expected to soar 334%. Not 34%, 334%. Over the next decade, that is something I've really never seen numbers that high when it comes to a specific job. It is one of the fastest growing jobs in the US, Forbes goes on to say. Once again, Tiff, that's great, but where do I go to take these courses? Yes, Tiff number two. Great question again. Great, good job. Here are some places you can go to take courses around artificial intelligence and that specialize in different roles in particular. One is Stanford's machine learning course on Coursera. You can tell I really love Coursera courses, mainly because they are taught by industry experts, a lot of individuals who work at very, very prominent universities or college, I mean Stanford. And another resource I don't hear too many people talking about, maybe because it's hidden a little bit, is NVIDIA's Deep Learning Institute courses. Both of the resources I mentioned offer a certification as well, which is great for you and your resume. All right, what about AI? If you are someone who might not be looking to become a machine learning engineer or even on the business side, AI and data specialist, how can you incorporate AI into your everyday work? This is another easy one, I think. I think they all really, if you are someone who is open to technology, learning, you can really fit these into your day-to-day job. With AI, it comes to being open to use new tools that come your way, educating yourself on AI. AI in itself, even saying it, it's such a broad term and there's so much under it. Here's an example of what I'm doing. In my day-to-day, I don't use AI or build AI, or I'm not a machine learning engineer. But what I did do is enroll in a post-grad course that is machine learning and AI hands-on. So this is a post-grad course that I'm going to be starting in February. Actually, on that note, let me know down in the comments if you want to learn more as I progress through this course. And it's going to be doing a little bit of both. One hand is technical, so coding with Python and really learning the ins and outs around all of these new technologies. Well, not new technologies, but new to me anyways, and to many people for actually building with them. And the other side is more of the business side around AI. Now, I'm not suggesting everyone out here has to go take a full-on course on it, but I would suggest even learning through some YouTube videos or some free courses online to really educate yourself as to the terms within artificial intelligence and also to where it's headed, because it's something that will affect every single person's job. Okay, with all these new technologies and roles popping up, it sounds like there's need for some security in the mix. You are not alone in thinking that. In fact, number three on the list is actually cybersecurity. Surprise, surprise, I hope not. We need more and more cybersecurity. It's one of the industries actually within tech or across the fields that is so in demand. It is continuing, the percentages for jobs within this field that are not being filled is pretty staggering. So what are some roles though within cybersecurity as a whole? Cybersecurity analyst, security engineer, penetration tester, incident responder, threat analysis, and the list goes on. This is another area, well, they're all really these areas where there's both technical opportunities and non-technical. A lot of people will either start their career out as technical and then maybe move into non-technical roles, or even vice versa, I've seen. Okay, and going back to data, we always bring it back to data, as I mentioned. What are the numbers? What are the percentages really telling us? The global cybersecurity market is actually projected to reach $375 billion by 2026. That is in 2 years. And cybersecurity job openings are expected to increase by 30% by 2030. Those numbers are pretty staggering. By the way, I found them on Cybersecurity and Security Infrastructure Agency's website. You already know what I'm gonna ask. Courses. I already got them ready. You didn't even need to ask. Here are some courses around cybersecurity. Cyberary's Ethical Hacking Fundamentals course is a really great course that offers a certification. Other courses are Offensive Security's Certified Ethical Hacker or CEH certification and SANS Institute Online Training. Now, with cybersecurity, it's a bit more tricky to recommend online courses because it really depends where you are at with your journey in cybersecurity. The biggest thing though is I would definitely recommend searching up very specific things within cybersecurity you are interested in. The good news is there are so many good resources online. Okay, well, once again, I'm not going to be going into cybersecurity in my career. At one point though, I really thought I was going to, but here are some key takeaways if you are like me and maybe aren't doing a full pivot into cybersecurity that you can bring into your day job right now or your day-to-day life, which in turn will help you stay ahead and really just be more, I mean, I'm trying to think of another word other than in demand, but it really comes back down to that because you're more knowledgeable, you're more prepared within your current job. Cybersecurity, I think, is a pretty obvious one where it's around the security. Don't click on links you're unfamiliar with. Don't open attachments or download attachments you're not familiar with. Make sure to do your due diligence when it comes to reading up on cybersecurity best practices, especially at your place of work. I mean, it depends on the size of where you work and what their security policies are, which can vary greatly, both good and bad. But one thing to really note is to stay diligent. Yes, you might be working on your work computer and it's not technically all your stuff, but think of it from the perspective of this company. If something was to go wrong because of something you've done, it would really affect your career for a very long time. All right, those are the three areas that are going to be future-proofed when it comes to roles under them or roles using them. And as I mentioned throughout this video, your role can use these different kind of sectors as long as you're open to it and wanting to continue to learn. I hope you found this video very helpful and valuable. I love making content for you. So once again, I gotta say it, leave in the comments any other topics you want me to cover, questions you have, and I'll see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.